Okay, writing people, this is my roommate, Mitchell. Mitchell, camera.
So,
writing people, Mitchell. Anyways, today what we're going to discuss is stereotypes of writing. And that's why he's here, to make sure I don't lie to you and say that I don't do things. You ready to get started?
Yep.
All right, the first one is, writers love coffee. I hate coffee. I don't drink coffee at all. Right? Never gotten into your coffee?
Yeah, I'm the only one that drinks coffee.
Yeah, he does not like to read. Writers own cats. That's obviously not true with me, because I got the piggies. They squeak a lot.
Yeah, they do. Yeah. A lot.
Yeah. And they pee on you, not me.
There's shit everywhere, too, man.
Writers are depressed or emotional. Not really. You know, sometimes, though. When I was writing that Triton book with Triton, that was... He messed me up a little. The man had some issues.
I guess you become the character.
Yeah. Yeah, you gotta get into the character's head, and sometimes it's a scary place to be. Writers spend much of their day alone. Yep.
Check.
Writers don't want to integrate with society. That's not true. Because I go a little, like, I get cabin fever and stir crazy being alone all the time. And I have to, like, get out of town. And you're the exact opposite. You're like, I'm around people too much. I need to hide in my hole.
Call it my man cave. You're sitting in it.
Yeah. This is his man cave, the theater. It's his Skrillex. Oh, I'm sorry. That's what I call Skyrim, just above him. Skyrim.
It's okay. I sold that. I had to get gas money.
Writers are nerds. You better be nice. I'm not. I played college rugby. I mean, come on.
I played college rugby for 2 more semesters than you did, and I'm a nerd. Jeez.
You are a nerd. You love Skyrim. I don't know. Rugby players might be nerds. But I don't like video games. Isn't that like the requisite of being a nerd? You have to love video games.
No, you can get nerdy about anything, whether it's math or science or books. Or it's just a, I guess, a healthy obsession with something.
Healthy. Yeah. Your Skyrim editions.
That wasn't healthy, I know.
Writers complain about writer's block. Definitely not me. I don't think I've ever had writer's block. I'm usually telling you about the ideas I have, right? Actually, you give me a lot of ideas. Really messed up ideas. Like, hey, have you killed anybody with, like, flying squirrel dung lately?
That was a brilliant idea.
Writers are alcoholics. Yeah, I don't drink at all. I hate the taste of alcohol.
I just drinks every night.
Yeah, I just smashed all the time.
No, I don't think I've ever seen you drink. Except that one time with the Amarillo Sours.
Amaretto Sours?
Amaretto.
That's barely even alcohol. That's less than beer. I didn't even get drunk.
It's like a liqueur or something.
Yeah. What do we just do? Writers and alcohol. Writers like to do drugs. Once again, no.
Stimulants.
I do get overloaded on caffeine sometimes. And I take a pre-workout supplement.
Oh, yeah, the C4. That's such great.
And it's like legal meth or something like that. It just wires you and I'm up all night. Oh, this feeds nicely into this one. Writers are not morning people. No.
Well, you got a weird sleep schedule. It's like, you're a morning person, then you're a night person, then morning person.
Yeah, my circadian rhythm is not 24 hours, it's more like 30. So every night I stay up a little later and a little later and a little later. And then for like a week, I'm pulling normal schedule. Like I'm waking up at 8 o'clock and going to sleep, you know, 11 or midnight. Right now, I'm going to sleep at like 7 or 8 o'clock in the morning. And I get up about 4 o'clock in the afternoon.
That's why I see you ever. It's
working like I'm like, bye! Have fun at school, I'm going to bed.
You have no idea how envious I am, and then just like, get the fuck out of here, God.
Okay, we're gonna pull up another website, that one's done. An emo teenager. Was I an emo teenager?
No, I think Josh is the only emo teenager we knew.
Yeah, our friend Josh, the one we replaced with a guinea pig. brown pig, his name is Josh. We replaced him because the other Josh didn't want to live with us. And then it turns out the other Josh is allergic to guinea pigs. So not only did we replace him, we kept him from ever moving in.
Who knew, man?
I was the high school science dropout. This is a list of, like, stereotypical typewriters. I liked science in elementary school, but, like, high school, I remember when we got to chem.
A good one.
Yeah. In the 10th grade, like, science got real all of a sudden, and math got into it, and I hated science after that. Oh, that was bad. Okay, another. We've done the drink coffee. Drink tea. I do like hot tea.
Yeah.
I drink that oolong tea, which is Chinese restaurant tea. I like that. I'm not fond of other teas. I've tried English breakfast and, what's that, Earl Grey?
Earl Grey, yeah.
Yeah, I didn't like that too much, but I love oolong tea. Wear flannel shirts. I wear t-shirts and polos. That's about it. I do not have a sense of fashion, though.
I don't think I've ever seen you in a flannel shirt.
No. Yeah. Oh, this one's... Man, you should be the writer. This next one's you, too. Own obscure band shirts that no one really knows. Are you wearing one right now? Oh, that would be so great if you're wearing your Flogging Molly shirt. This kid should be a writer. He doesn't even read. Poor.
Sometimes.
Poor. I am poor.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Poor.
I think you're making below the poverty line at this point.
Very much below. Ink-stained fingers. Nope.
Oh.
When I was changing my typewriter, written though they were.
Shit.
Cerebral. I guess so. I do examine things most of the time. Obsessed. I don't know. Maybe a little bit. I'm kind of like ADD, and I can't stay obsessed with things for long. Sensitive. I'm a very sensitive
guy.
You
have ADD, so it affects your obsessions?
Yeah, I can't stay obsessed with things. I get bored quickly.
Okay, I believe it.
Okay. Authors are sensitive. I'm a sensitive guy. I am. I love my little piggies. They're so cute. I saw a bunny picture and I was like, oh! And Mitchell's like, I want a puppy.
No, I think it means sensitive towards humanity and society.
Ah, screw people. I mean, I love you all.
Please subscribe.
Authors are cold. No, I usually get hot.
Yeah. I think that kind of ties in with the sensitivity thing.
Oh, I thought it meant actual.
Yeah, you're cold-blooded, man. Reptile.
Underfed. Yeah, a little bit. I eat poorly.
I think I picked my teeth with toothpicks that are bigger than you. Yeah.
Thanks, Mom. Alcoholic. Nope. Oh, we've been through this one already. Oh, this is a good one. Can hear voices, sometimes, but not always, of dead people and or schizophrenic. What?
Later. No.
I've had conversations with myself while writing to make sure that I am... The dialogue makes sense.
That's...
But I know they're not there.
That's good.
Are bipolar. A little bit. I get into some weird moods sometimes.
I've seen some really two-faced people before, well, in terms of bipolar, and I don't think so.
Not bad, maybe a little emotionally erratic, not the same as bipolar.
Basically.
OCD, definitely not. I'm definitely a good enough person. That's why I have to do so many drafts on my novels. Because I'm like, that's good enough, I can't get that any better. And then I do another draft, I'm like, wow, I left that like that? That's why I do 5 or 6 drafts. Definitely not OCD. Oh, man. Generally obsessive, no. Scatterbrained, yeah.
Yeah.
Jerk. Abuse, some kind of addiction. I have a fluffy addiction.
Hey, you bought a lot of guinea pigs really quickly.
I did. I have a lot of piggies. They're so cute. Depending on the age, sex of a person, smoke cigars and or cigarettes. Never smoked. Don't want to. Messy. Little bit. I don't like to clean, but I do like to keep things somewhat tidy. But I can get messy at times, especially when I'm working hard.
I've seen worse.
can predict human behavior well. Sometimes. A lot of times I can. Some people, like you, it's like, what the heck? I've known you since the first grade. I still know what you're going to do.
I like to keep things interesting.
Playing Jane or Joe? Yeah, a little bit. I don't really dress up.
Homely.
Shut up, I'm not homely. I'm beautiful. Eccentric.
Yeah. Jake.
Yeah. Oh, man. Self-involved, if not arrogant and self-centered. I don't know if I'm really arrogant. I have a lot of self-doubt, especially when I'm querying people.
I don't know. You really debated me when we were trivia about that Scottish flag. I mean, you really believed it.
Wasn't it Finnish? Oh, it was Scottish.
It was Scottish.
Got it wrong. Yeah, that was bad.
Okay, moments of arrogance.
Okay. Sadomasochistic. How do you say that again? Sadomasochistic. Where you like to hurt people and receive pain. No, I don't even like needles.
Masochist.
Yeah, sadomasochist. Okay.
Yeah, I don't think you're a sadist.
No. Clever and smart. Yeah, buddy.
Sure.
Perceptive. Yeah, I notice things. We've been living in this apartment for like 6 months, and there was a Publix right next to it, like the shopping center right next to it.
Yeah.
And we're driving along, and we're like, Mitchell, stop in Publix. Let's pick up some ice cream or something. He's like, where's Publix at? We've been living there for 6 months, and he didn't know.
I get all my food from Aldi. Come on.
Persistent. Yeah, if it's something I want, I can usually go after it pretty hard. Imaginative or fanciful? Well, God, I hope so.
I think that would,
What else would I write?
I don't know if that's a stereotype. I think that's a requirement.
Unrealistic. No. Not really. Okay, let's see. We'll do this, just this last one. Wears glasses. Are you sure you're not a writer?
Well,
no, I don't wear glasses. I have perfect vision. Only one in my family with perfect vision.
Really? Oh, yeah. Dana wears glasses?
She's blind as a bat. Anyways. Can't tell between reality and fiction. I can't do that. Clinically insane. Yes, I'm diagnosed. This is my asylum. Stays up all night.
I'm here because I have an addiction with muffins.
Muffin button.
I found it.
Stays up all night. Yeah, I stay up all night. Wear sweaters all the time. I don't own a sweater. Wear funny hats. Are you sure you're not?
Oh, fuck you.
Bases characters off people I know. Yeah, he's in every book I've written. That book I wrote as a series is actually called The Bully Trap. It's under contract. He's the main character. He's the bully.
You wrote a series called Bully Trap?
It's a single book.
Yeah, keep me up to date with this shit.
I'm sorry. Socially undeveloped. I do okay. I'm a little shy, but I do okay.
I've seen worse. I think you're doing good.
Doesn't listen to anything other than classical, new age, Celtic, insert, similar genre here. So I don't know.
Similar genre?
I think they're talking about like just weird stuff.
Oh, just kind of off the
wall.
Nothing
mainstream. That's not... I listen to classic rock mostly. I listen to like dubstep every once in a while, but...
That's so funny.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, last one. I'm misanthropic. No? No. Okay. Well, that was our list of writer stereotypes. Did I live up to most of them? No.
I'd say less than half.
Less than half. So I'm either not a writer, and he is because he lived up to most of them, or...
What's a writer?
Or I don't live up to them at all. Anyways, thanks for watching, everybody. This has been Mitchell. If you like him, you can subscribe here because he doesn't have a YouTube channel.
It's unfortunate.
Yeah. And maybe he'll be back later. Maybe not. Anyways, peace out, writing people. We'll see you later.